Standard Finance Minister Piyush Goyal gave a populist interim budget. There is something for everyone in the budget, especially the middle class and the farmers. However, one of the major announcements in the budget is a full tax rebate for individual taxpayers with an annual income up to Rs. 5 lakh. Actually, this necessarily means that individuals with a gross income of Rs. 6.5 lakhs and those who are invested in provident fund or other insurance schemes, they need not pay income tax actually. So it wouldn't be prudent to expect any policy announcements in an interim budget. But still, many major issues like job creations were not addressed by the finance minister. So then again, serious questions needs to be asked about the fiscal prudence in the country and the kind of tax estimates that's been given in the budget for the fiscal year 2020.
Fiscal prudence is too much to ask for in a budget in an election year. The government clearly did not have any intention of fulfilling the requirement under the Fiscal Responsibility and Budget Management Act of keeping the fiscal deficit at 3% of the GDP. In fact, it even missed the budget target of 3.3%. The fiscal deficit for the financial year 2020 is now pegged at 3.4% of the GDP. It is a minor slippage, but it is despite the claims of record tax collection. So what are the ill effects of this higher fiscal deficit? The breach of discipline may affect India's sovereign ratings. It may hurt the confidence of foreign investors and may lead to higher taxes when the government tries to fill the gap, and it leaves little room for interest rate cuts.
In its final months in power, the Modi government has left no stone unturned to woo the farming community in the country. In the budget that Finance Minister Piyush Goyal presented today, he has announced a slew of measures to woo the farming community. One of the primary measures that Mr. Goyal announced in today's budget was the 6,000 rupees that will be transferred directly to the farmers. About 12 crore farmers from India would be benefited by this, and the government has kept aside about 75,000 crore for the scheme. Another key announcement made by Mr. Piyush Goyal in today's interim budget was the scheme for unorganized sector workers. Now, our domestic workers, maids, etc. will now be assured a sum of rupees 3,000 of monthly pension, which they'll start getting after they attain an age of 60 years. This will be majorly funded by the central government. Finally, one of the important points that cannot be missed from Piyush Goyal's interim budget today is the 10-point vision that he shared for the next decade for India. Goyal announced that the aim of the current government is to make India a $5 trillion economy in the next 5 years. And more science-oriented institutions, building a digital economy, creating about 1 million jobs. Green India, development of the coastal economy are the important points that cannot be missed from the 10-point vision for the next decade.
And so here we are, end of play on Budget Day. And Prime Minister Modi and his partner, Minister Piyush Goyal, will be immensely satisfied with what they have unveiled for the people of India. A grand vision 2030 that makes India a modern, high-growth society. And on the way, they take India past a $5 trillion economy onto a $10 trillion economy. And 6 months ago, Ayushman Bharat was one of the first indicators of what was being planned. 50 crore beneficiaries. Beyond the specifics, look at the numbers. 50 crore and today is 22 crore. And that we're talking about 70 crore plus people who are being targeted. And that's not a bad number for Prime Minister Modi and Mr. Amit Shah. And they'll take it gladly. That's not a bad start for 2019 with 3 odd months to go. Well, the dream is still young, but they've started well. Let's see how it goes.